welcome to the Brookfield Board of Selectmen's meeting Tuesday, October 4th. As everyone may please rise for the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everyone. We'll start with approving the warrants. I will entertain a motion to approve the expense warrant for 922, payroll for 927, and expense for 928.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Entertain a motion to approve the selectmen minutes for 6-7, 21, 28, and 7-26.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Entertain a motion to acknowledge the reports and minutes of the Cultural Council and EMS for 9-12 and 9-16, respectively.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Announcements, a reminder that the 38th Annual Apple Country Fair will be held from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Saturday, October 8th. It's this Saturday. On the historic Brookfield Town Common, highlights include over 70 craft vendors, live music, quilt wrap. Is that raffle?
It's raffle, that's what raffle. It's called.
Raffle?
Raffle.
Right.
I guess I'm not in that mix. Children's activities, apple pie contest, food vendors, bake table, raffles, and much more. For information, please visit applecountryfair.com. Mr. Wallinen, District A to Senator Ann Gobi, will be holding office hours at the Brookfield Town Hall from 2:30 to 3:30 p.m. Monday, October 24th. Message from the Recreation Committee, trick-or-treat and Halloween events will be held Halloween night, Monday, October 31st. Trick-or-treat from 6 to 7 p.m. in the Village and Common area. Meet at Fire Station for Parade on the Common. We'll leave promptly at 7 p.m. Costume contest and gazebo upon arrival at the Common. As always, candy donations are being accepted at the library and elementary school in an effort to help those who live in the trick-or-treat area. Any other announcements? Hearing none, anybody wish to address the board this evening? Welcome, sir.
Evening.
Good evening.
Chapter 90. I asked you at several meetings, 3-4 meetings, about the Chapter 90 money to be used for the bridge. And I was told at 4 meetings that the money cannot be used because it hasn't been approved, so on and so forth. I talked to the State Highway DOT. They told me the money was all approved for the Commonwealth back in April. So I'm not too happy about this, and neither is the advisory board. The money is there, and it can be used for the bridge. Number two, the secretary to the highway department said, well, we can't get that money. It hasn't been approved, whatever. That's not true. So I'm going to give you a little education tonight. The way this Chapter 90 money works is the state holds the money. Everyone in the Commonwealth gets X number of dollars, depending on population, roads, and how much people make on their income. Each town, but with that formula, then each town gets something. We, Brookfield, got $168,000, and it's been sitting there. It sits in their bank in Boston. When we need something, we apply for it. And once we apply for it, they say yes. Then they say, okay, do your project. When we get invoices for the project, we submit it to them, they give us a check. And then we pay the vendors, or whoever, or we pay our own highway guys, whatever, providing it's approved from them, and we do the bidding process correctly too. If it's a big job, we have to go out to bid and all that good stuff. So what I'm kind of concerned and upset about is, I was told at 4 meetings that that money is not allocated and we don't know if we can use it yet. And that wasn't true. That wasn't true at all. So, I forgot to shut that off. So I want to set that straight. So the money is sitting there. The advisory board took a vote that we should use half of it. It's just a recommendation by the board that we should use half of that money, whatever half the cost of the bridge is. Me, I voted to use more of it, but that's okay. That's the way the vote went. I don't know what the costs are, or you got $168,000 and you can leave something in there, but a good part of this should go towards a bridge.
So, not to cut you short and not to move things around, but agenda item...
Well, I usually do, anyway.
I never cut you short, David. Agenda item number two is approving Chapter 90 requests. We have three of them in here.
Okay.
If it's okay with the board, I'm gonna recommend that we pass this folder to the advisory committee before we take action on it, based on their vote.
Okay.
Are we okay with that?
I would only say that David's partly correct, that the money may be sitting there, but it has to be an approved project, and that project not be a repair. And so I would think that we need to get certain approvals as it relates to the bridge,
well,
and then go from there.
I'm gonna speak my piece, because I spoke... What do we have, 30... If we can just turn the cell phones off, please.
Yeah.
Thank you. We're in a really weird political climate right now with less than 40 days to a national election, mm-hmm. and everybody's so impolitically correct. I find myself extremely politically correct in these meetings because obviously there's a camera on us. But in my discussions with Dave and his committee, I just had it either a week or two ago. They called me in on a conference call and I spoke. I am adamantly 100% against 100% of the bridge repair from Chapter 90 money. But with that being said, we had a reporter that went out and beat the drums for us, and I thank him very much for the article that got things moving for the temporary bridge. And then we had a retort, basically Mass DOT coming back at us. Mass DOT dropped the ball on this. I spoke with Representative Berthium last week, who actually got chewed out by Mass DOT as well for that article. He had nothing to do with it. Just that article moved the bridge along, probably saved this town of Brookfield 2 months, so I commend it. But part of them dropping the ball was constructing the new bridge in East Brookfield that joined that road. And through communication with our highway department, we chose the town of Brookfield not to fix Dunbrook because it would just close the entire road. So we were working with the state. The state on average takes 5 to 6 years to make any project work. So to do this in a couple months, I think we're in a good position. But part of that discussion was to allocate $50,000 from Chapter 90 money for the repair of that bridge. We had conversations in these meetings about that, fiberglass wrap of the columns, all that good stuff. We were gonna allocate $50,000 of Chapter 90 money for that. So there's no doubt in my mind, unless the world ceased to exist and things have changed, but in the political world, and that's where I come back full around, unless that's changed, we can still use money for that project. And I'm okay with $50,000 allocating for it. But we are requesting a lot of money out of Chapter 90 in this. And I think we all know how Chapter 90 works. We're allotted a certain X amount of dollars, and then the selectmen have to sign off, and then we have to basically apply through the state, and they have to sign off.
They have to approve it.
But the state has signed off on these. These are projects that are completed, except for one. One of the projects in here, the four, is a catch basin truck for $10,000 for the acquisition. I mean, is it $10,000? I think $30,000 for the truck. We allocated $10,000 at the special town meeting, at the annual town meeting, in the fleet account for that project. So I think that will be approved as well. So the things have to be discussed in here, but it has some. Dave asking to do it with an open mind. I didn't hear the tail end of that conversation, but I'm assuming part of my the using 100% of Chapter 90 for Dunbrook.
I didn't say 100%.
You wanted 100%.
No, I wanted to leave 20,000 close. I just wanted to leave 20,000 in there. You know, somewhere in that range, in case we get a road washed out or something.
Is there a dead limit? A limit when these have to be signed? So many days?
I don't think so.
Because when is the advisory board meeting again?
We were just presented this today.
When are you meeting again?
13th, I think. 13th. I have to check.
There's plenty of time.
So you're going to let them have the originals, not just copies of them? Because we can't read just, I mean, we have to get the advisory board's approval to do this?
We don't, but when we're coming up to a special town meeting, which we're kind of, we always obviously have a special town meeting to set the tax rate, but the big ticket item is going to be the bridge.
Mm. And I understand that's the big ticket
item. The advisory committee is there to advise. Yep. If we're just going to do everything that we want, why have an advisory committee?
No, I understand that, Steve, but I thought this was selectmen's approval, not just the advisory.
It is, but I think with what Dave is, and that's why I'm taking it off the agenda right away through public access, through Dave's discussion of his committee, I think they should see what's coming down the pike of what bills we've already paid. I think there's what, there's Weber Road in here, there's, is it Upper, or is it Lake Road in here?
Could be.
Yeah.
And then the catch basin truck.
But again, it's appropriate because these are things that will be on the warrant or potentially on the warrant, and that is the role of the advisory committee.
And then it's us to voice our opinions as well and correct. Say yay or nay.
I would say before we move forward with Dunbrook and as far as the allocation of the monies, the approval process and the like, the highway department is not represented this evening. And certain suggestions were made as to how we acted or did not act. And I would suggest that the next time we have a conversation around Chapter 90 and the advisory board has some comment to make, that the highway department be represented.
So you might
want to put this on your agenda, Dave.
Oh, yeah.
And invite Cindy and or Herb to that next meeting to discuss it.
Right. Okay, but getting back to my point here is...
So Linda made a great recommendation. Can you make copies of these and then place them in their box so we don't lose
the
original?
Yeah, they should be copies.
Thank you.
So getting back to my point, when this money came into this town four times, and I've been to these meetings, and you said, well, we can't touch that money, and we have no if it's coming to the state. And it was already sitting there.
Cindy had said it, yes.
Yes. Well, I'm not mentioning any names.
But she said that it had to be certified.
It was already done. I mean,
again, conjecture on the part of a party, and that individual is not in the room. So I would suggest that we table it for now, unless we have to do some other activity.
His discussion in public access.
Oh, he's free to discuss it. However,
but it moved number two into their committee, right. And I think we're good. Right.
But if you listen to me closely, I didn't mention any names when they went present, Clarence.
They aren't present here now.
Who's here now?
The highway department is not represented in this room.
That's right. That's right. But I did not mention any employee from the highway that is not present in this room. And if I did that, then I'd be in violation. But I did not do that.
I don't think it's a violation.
Well, whatever you want to call it.
You're quoting an individual, and I don't think that's a violation.
No, however you want to look at it. So anyway, I made my point as far as that goes. We volunteer our time for this advisory board and the members, because I've heard them all grumbling. And we don't get cooperation, and we get lied to, and you switch things around, and we don't get figures, and we're not happy about it.
I'm bringing that to the table tonight, too. I'm giving you a whole stack of figures for your next meeting.
All right, so I think how much you should, this money from Chapter 90, you should try to allocate as much as you can from the bridge.
There's big ticket items in here, so you're going to want to take a look at those.
Well, I think you should put a freeze on it, and I talked to the state also, and they said you can use that money for the bridge, for repairing it or replacing it. All Chapter 90 money can be used for bridges, roads, and certain equipment pertaining to highways, you know, to the roads.
Again, Mr. Chairman, the highway department is not here.
Yeah. But at the end of the day, Clarence, we have to make the decision, so I'm not opposed to listening to them.
Oh, no, I'm not opposed to listening.
But understand, I have one of three, have no problem approving all of those requests.
I don't have a problem with her approving him either.
No.
I'm not discussing here tonight what you have in that folder.
But if we take that money out of Chapter 90, X amount of dollars from your X amount of dollars, we're only going to have X amount of dollars.
Yeah, and that means the stabilization is going to drop lower than it is now.
Not stabilization. Well, if we take it from stabilization.
Well, how are you going to pay for the bridge?
We can raise and appropriate. We can take it from stabilization.
I don't think the townspeople are going to want their taxes.
I asked you 2 months ago to have the discussion with Al to see where we are with the Prop 2.
That's being in the works. Right. That's in the works.
And so, if there was good news in the last week or so, as far as the collections over the last week or so have, in fact, improved. So there could be some money there that we're not thinking about.
Well, our levy limit's set, so.
Right.
Right. But this cash that came into this town.
Yeah, but it doesn't work that way, unfortunately, for the levy.
Right. It's not like it goes into a bank and then we can say we've got extra money. It's not going to work that way. You know what I'm saying? And I don't care if I'm politically correct or not in this town.
I'm right there with you,
you can be politically correct. I don't care.
I'll try to be politically correct in front of
I don't care. I just tell it the way it is, and if people don't like it, too bad.
I try to as well, but I do.
I really don't care, Steve. I'm volunteering my time, and the people on that board is volunteering their time.
I sat there as well, Dave. I understand completely.
Okay, but now you're in this seat, so we should get some more cooperation. So you've been there.
I'm cooperating.
Okay.
But just because I don't agree doesn't mean I'm not cooperating.
No, I didn't say that either.
All right.
All right, so we'll discuss that at a later time. You're still, so, okay, that's fine. A lot of people in town think we're getting another police cruiser because the way the paper read and everybody said, oh, we just got another cruiser. That was for the police chief. I just want everybody in town to know that we're not getting another. They thought we're getting another, replacing one of the cruisers. And I've heard it from a lot of people, so I just want to correct it right now.
We replaced the police chief's cruiser,
right,
and that was the only cruiser that we've replaced, right, but I'm going to replace in this near future.
I mean, I know that, you know that, but the people out there are...
Do you agree?
100%.
Okay, thank you.
The paper wrote it wrong and said that I approached the board asking permission to put an article on at the special town meeting, which is absolutely incorrect. It was a past town meeting that we already approved it. But it was the paper misunderstanding and writing problem.
That's my point, because I have some pretty upset people that, you know, even giving me crap. I mean, what are you yelling at me for?
Because you're a volunteer on the advisory committee.
Right.
Dave.
Did you? I asked you what I said to them. Did you show up at the town meeting? Their answer was no. I said, I don't want to hear you then, you know? But anyway, I just wanted to straighten that out. If everybody in town said, you know, we're not getting another police cruiser. I won't say some of the comments I got, but that's another story. Another suggestion I have is that the highway, when they cut trees, they were doing trees on Allen Road. They were doing a very nice job.
Past week. I was going to bring that up. I did not get back to Herb. If you can send a message out to Herb, the resident home that they were at for the past 2 days called me personally on my cell and had the utmost praise and gratitude towards Herb and his men.
What street was that?
On Allen Road. And especially for Herb himself as well.
Yeah, they did a good job.
Very professional and very courteous.
What my suggestion is, besides all that good job, is they don't wear hard hats when they're doing the tree work. I just picked up on that. I think they should have hard hats on when they're dropping stuff down, if it bounces up off the road.
I would agree. So can you just send an email out to Cindy and request that we make sure they're wearing hard hats, unless you guys disagree? Okay.
I didn't get an answer last week on, we got talking about 20 things here, about the roller rink and the properties that we have. When are we going to have an auction on some of this, to get rid of some of this stuff?
Right now, never, until it's assessed.
Okay.
And that was the answer that you got 2 weeks ago?
Well, what do you mean by never now?
If we're planning right now, there's no plan for it. So that there's no plan to auction off any property down on that site.
Okay.
The assessment has to be completed, and I would assume it's probably going to take a year or two, if not longer.
I do have a report from last week's meeting, when it's appropriate.
Okay.
But I think it's appropriate now, if you want to.
Yeah. We did meet with Mass Historical last week. Their archaeologist that we were working with in the scope of supply was out ill, and so we've been delayed by getting confirmation of the scope of supply and the contract. So we met last week. One of the other concerns that the Quabuck clan had was the digging at the site, and we have reached agreement on what can and can't be done as far as the digging process. So we now do have also an agreement with the clan.
Are they 100% against?
They were
using before, the X-ray.
Not the clan, but
the state.
The state was opposed to geophysical. The clan preferred geophysical because of the impact or the lack of impact.
So the impact, and they're against it because of the cost?
Right. And so the two have come together. And what we will have is there will be a series of what are called shovel test pits. There will be a series of those. But what we'll do beforehand is there will be geophysical magnetometer, ground penetrating radar, those kinds of things, to minimize the amount of places where one might dig or one might find resources.
Didn't they call that scrapings?
It's scrapings. We're not digging.
We're
scraping.
We're scraping, yeah.
Yes.
That's
that's
very intricate.
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
yes. Quite.
But the experts that I walked with years ago, just looking at it, their knowledge, I think they kind of pointed out where it could possibly be.
Yeah.
So there's just
correct.
Walking it. They have a
yeah.
pretty good idea.
I know when we went down, I remember going down in the spring, and it was the same thing. They're pretty sure where they know a lot of them are.
So with his absence in this meeting, we're waiting for the scope of supply to come back to us. It was to be a June to June timeframe. They've now extended the period to September, or trying to get the work done by September. But yes, we will be talking next September about what we found. And again, when it comes to the roller rink, I do not expect it that property would ever find its way into the marketplace again, to be very clear.
Why is that? A lot of people have been questioning it.
Well, and the neighbors that have joined us, and I have documents tonight if you'd like a document, digging in that area is a serious concern.
Yeah.
Because of the artifacts that have been found over the last 50 years.
At the roller rink? Are you talking in the campground?
Side.
Yes.
Yeah, on the sides of the roller rink.
Yep.
I'm talking off of Pine Lane.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm absolutely talking roller rink off Pine Lane.
Well, why is it at that particular
Dave, it's
piece
that whole area.
No, that it's whole that whole area.
The particular piece that we have is the least touched piece of land in that area. Everything else is developed.
Okay, so we're going to test that too then.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. This
well, that answers my question because I was wondering why we.
And plus,
you know,
it's all grown up around there too, and it.
But you have to. So, for the people that are questioning this, you have to let them know that not only this board, but three boards in the past that have dealt with this, and not only the three boards, but the townspeople at the meeting believe 100% that this land is sacred and it needs to be treated with honor and respect. And that's what this board and any, as far as I'm concerned, any future board is going to do.
Well, I'm not questioning that. What about all the other houses on Pine Lane?
There's nothing we can do. It's private property.
Okay.
This property is what the.
Why do you think there's something at that particular site?
I think there's something throughout the whole area.
Yeah, the whole area.
And if the readings that I've had opportunity, there were 10,000 people resident in this area before the contact period. This place was the 495 or a stop off on 495.
Back in that day. So nobody found anything when we put all these houses up around here.
Oh yes, they did.
And that's why
is that documented?
That's why we're confident, Dave, because the campground is documented.
Yeah.
And no one did anything.
Exactly. And
there was a gentleman that had found things and
they found it. They documented it.
He
took it and.
And there's things up at UMass, I think.
Springfield. Oh, that was the guy who was going in the campground, jigging around.
There was no respect on that property whatsoever. Yeah. It's a travesty.
Right. Sad.
And then there's even there also over on the Quayside side also, because they were going to put in more condos over there, and they found some Indian relics
and
we should have
stopped at that time. And again, in the meetings that we've had with the residents, we've handed out the what do you do if you find kind of document from the state. And it basically says cease and desist.
Yeah.
And again, as we're on the camera and the chief's here in the room, the chief has been having extra patrols in that area over time to make sure that we're not finding people just wandering around doing things and digging on that site. Because it is a protected and needs to be a protected site.
After all these years and all that digging.
Sad.
It is.
It's sad.
All right, I got one other thing. When are we going to get a temporary bridge put in down?
We're hearing in less than a month. Everything's been approved. Things are in transit.
More Jersey barriers brought down there today.
So when do you think the bridge is going to be installed? Temporary bridge.
We saw by the end of November the latest.
Cindy said October.
Was it October?
No, I thought it said end of October.
Yes.
Maybe I saw November. It was November 1st.
Yeah.
Okay,
so it's coming soon then.
I think our biggest problem right now is lights, unless that got solved. I'd asked Donnie last week to see if he could get some.
Are you going to allow trucks to go over? And
it's rated, it's engineered, so whatever.
Is it going to be one lane or two?
One lane.
One lane?
That's where we need the light.
For local traffic only.
For local
so you're going to let these water trucks go over this bridge too?
I don't see how it's rated for it.
I wouldn't think
so. That means we're going to have signs, and that means the police are going to have to enforce it then.
That's what they're there for.
That's what they're there for.
Okay, so about a month. All right, very good.
All right, thank you, sir. Anybody else wish to address the board this evening? All right, item number one, town hall renovation. Clarence had met last week. The floor is yours, sir.
Right, and the learning, if there's a major learning in this process, is that they would prefer, or not prefer, really would be looking if they were going to be permitting, that nothing be done in this hall or upstairs or major kinds of things, impacts. until we're ready, in the case of, it really gets to the restrooms, is that they would prefer that this room not be carved up.
Ever.
No. If, for example, we were to afford the elevator, that, and again, there would were to be no other choices as far as the facilities that would be required to host that kind of a number of people, then it really does then force you into the architect's design of using this area here as the additional restroom. I think the other thing that comes from the meeting is the need to work with the most recent plumbing codes and the like to understand where they're headed because of this most recent conversation around the numbers of restrooms and the types of restrooms.
We met with the plumbing inspector a couple months ago.
And the only caution was to make sure that we're as current as we can be.
Which we attempted to do.
Yeah, and absolutely, for sure. But what the preference would be is to use the assessor's office for any activity.
So you were going to say
something? I sat in on the meeting and I was just observed because, you know, we didn't have it posted. And I did, they did explain the whole thing out. He said that they didn't want us to cut the building up at all. They said, with the plan on, we talked about, you know, like putting in a hallway here and doing some doors and things, and he said we can't do that either. He said we'd have to go more on the lines putting in cubicles.
So ever?
Nope.
Yep. Because of the historic nature of the building.
The historic nature.
And that's what I got out of that email, and I am dumbfounded. All the money that we've wasted. The only thing we can do is put an elevator in, renovate the top, and I don't see anybody doing that.
I'm very concerned. At the same time, he did talk about the access to money. Again, it would be coming at 50.
But there's nothing we can do here. All we'd have is a hall upstairs.
You'd have a huge hall upstairs.
And Yes. Nobody in this town, there's going to be a handful of people, yes. But I don't think I would support. We're talking $1 million to put an elevator in to get a room upstairs in.
The estimate is $888,000. Half of that money could come from grants and the like, but the other half would be something that the town would have to consider.
Yeah, you talked about all these different grants. It would be like a half and half. The town would come up with
grants.
A portion.
That not only puts us at a dead stop, but it puts us more than 100 yards back.
Well, I think we need to consider the idea of a second restroom and improving on what we have.
I'd argue, why do we even need a restroom? Let's just make the one we have currently ADA accessible.
That's a choice.
I think based on this conversation, I think that's kind of our only choice. And the only reason why we involve bringing that one up to ADA is because it's required by law.
Yeah. Well, I think we need to move forward with the ADA stuff for sure.
We do. Absolutely.
I met with Tantaswit last week at the high school. He was in a hold pattern because of the whole discussion, because when I brought him in last year, it was for that small bathroom, mm-hmm. bringing it up. And I said, no, we've allocated money to turn the assessors. So now I just have to, I don't know.
I think we ought to noodle on the idea of taking advantage of the assessor space.
Yeah, I agree.
I think it's a waste of money.
No, I think we should. And also because of the way, you know, the new septic system was put in here now, because the sink, we shouldn't even have the sink. We should disconnect the sink.
What does that have to do with the bathroom?
Well, we have to put in for what we have to do in that area too is put an area for the custodian so he will have like a mop sink.
That's your idea of what to do behind this. Yeah,
behind there too.
I'm not a proponent of making that into a bathroom anymore.
Well, here's the deal. There are monies that would be or potentially could be allocated from other sources for grant cycles into February, CBGD as an example. And again, that potentially could fund, including the elevator and those kinds of things. So I think we need to look for those kinds of funding sources and see where it goes.
I think that would be a catalyst on moving forward. Maybe if we could get the upstairs renovated, then we would think about turning that into a bathroom. But if we're not going to touch the upstairs, I don't recommend turning that into a bathroom.
Hard decisions.
That's where I am.
Yep. Hard decisions.
So what is that grant process and that cycle?
Both Mass Historical plus CBGD are February timeframe, 2017, as far as applications.
And when are they going to announce the...
In the case of Mass Historical, they did announce in June. And you'd have a year on those dollars.
Now, is that something you can apply for both?
Oh, yeah.
Yourself, you can handle that?
Well,
I'm being serious.
Yeah. Oh, and again, I'm running out of bandwidth myself, but it would be certainly something I could do.
You realize we have money for an assistant for that
and
grant writing.
And what I would think we would want to do is to have a conversation to decide how we want to do that. And again, Bill Simpson's not here tonight, and I would kind of defer to Bill as well, because he's looking into the CBGG information.
My heart breaks for Bill. He's been working so hard on this.
Yep. Well, and again, if we were to pursue something, we'd put a small committee together and figure it out, or attempt to figure it out.
I disagree with the committee.
Well, I'm just saying one or two people. I think we're talking two or three people. I'm not talking.
I think you, Bill.
You and yourself.
Well, if I need to.
Yeah.
Or, you know, a grant writer.
Right. Well, and then that would be, well, I'm talking small. I'm not talking...
I wouldn't deem as a committee. I would just individuals working.
Yeah.
So I think we're in a hold pattern until possibly June?
Could be.
Well,
other than in the meantime to go out and... determine whether the monies are available and what we might do to pursue them.
And wasn't there some talk too between you and Bill about taking the money that we already have and like getting it transferred around so we could apply that for some of our funds?
Well, I pulled the article.
Yeah.
And it really talks about the first floor. It doesn't talk about specifics down there at the
what
bottom.
We might want to do as well is in our special town is have a non-binding referendum to see what they want with this town hall.
Yeah.
That's a good
because
idea.
It really starts the force it does, Steve. I mean, do you turn this into senior living? I mean, that's what other towns have done when they come to these kinds of conclusions.
But then where do we go for a town hall?
Then we take the affinity property ourselves, clean it up, and put an annex up there.
Or maybe. Mm. All to be discussed.
All to be.
I'm almost set. Thank you.
Okay.
Well, thank you for your time on that, as disappointing as it is.
Wasn't fruitful, but we tried.
Item number two, we've already discussed. Item number three, we have an individual requesting to be appointed to the Rec Committee. Mr. Blake has been involved with town sports for 8 years. The last is town coordinator of the Brookfield Little League. After attending rec meetings for the past year, he feels that he could help the committee continue to provide the children of the town opportunities in sports and recreation activities. Entertain a motion to appoint Mr. Blake to the rec committee to expire, where are we at, June 30th? Is it a one-year appointment?
Yeah.
2017?
I will make that recommendation.
I'll second it.
Motion?
On the motion.
Okay. Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. We have two individuals that wish to serve the town of Brookfield. I would invite both, along with the chief, up to introduce themselves. Good evening, sir. The floor is yours. No, they can sit.
I'll stand.
That's better. Yep.
I'm requesting the appointment of three reserve officers, Julian Niter, Michael Green, and Jose Vallejo. These two reside in Worcester. Jose resides in Southbridge. He was unfortunately not able to make it here today. His work schedule, he couldn't get out of work. Julian is a full-time police dispatcher for the WPI Police Department. She has an associate in criminal justice from Quinn Sigerman. Michael has a bachelor's degree in sociology from Bucknell University. Jose is pursuing his criminal justice associate's degree from Quinn Sigerman College as well. I interviewed a total of 10 people for the positions, and these three come out on top. Not so much for their law enforcement experience, because they have limited law enforcement experience, but I think their personality and their work ethic, and I think they're going to be a real good fit for the town. All three have completed the Reserve Intermittent and Police Academy and are ready to go and start FTO once they're appointed. So I'd like to introduce you to Jillian and Michael.
Welcome.
Nice to meet
you. Any questions for our candidates?
No, if the chief has interviewed him and if he feels they're a good fit, I will take his recommendation.
Really, you're just going to defer to that? Yeah. No questions? they're up there shaking and sweating? You know?
No.
But the resumes look good. I am impressed. More so that you choose to want to serve the town of Brookfield.
Yes.
We make the speech every time, or at least I do, that this is the number one out of the 351 cities and towns. And this is number one. This is the best place you can live, and the people make it. And if we do appoint you, community policing is huge in this town. Get out there, show your face, be warm, loving, kind. Chase clowns away on Halloween. Ooh. Was that impolitically correct? I'm sorry. Do you have any questions for us? what are you laughing at, Chief? Come on.
Clown thing.
It's absolutely ridiculous.
For the record, there's been no sightings around here or anything. I think there'll be hysteria coming. But
I'm going to be dressed up as Pikachu and carry a bat around with me, see what we can do. So I will entertain a motion to appoint Mr. Green, Ms. Help me?
Niter.
And Mr. Vallejo for terms to expire June 30th, 2017.
I will make that motion.
As reserve police officers for the town of Brookfield. First and second, motion and second. Any discussion? Mm-hmm. Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Any other business, Chief?
I don't, and you guys don't.
You out there looking for another cruiser?
Two more.
Well, we need three more, technically, right? Thank you, guys. Right,
thank
Stay
you.
Safe, everyone.
Thank you.
Item number five, setting meeting dates. We only have this month set.
Have one set until it's the 18th. And then after that, we have
the 18th. So we're into...
We have one on the 18th?
Yes.
Or 2 weeks from tonight.
Yeah, that's the 18th.
And do we need to do something, speaking of the town meeting, special town meeting, do we need to at least reserve something 2 weeks before as far as articles?
We had the dates and all that.
Yeah.
With the motion, we set our dates for the article submission.
They have to be in by the 28th.
We didn't, I sent out, on your recommendation, a second email asking that they please have them done for the 18th if possible.
Oh, okay, yes, all right.
The deadline hasn't changed, but out of courtesy, if they can send them, I would appreciate it.
Because we were thinking in the two-week cycle, our next meeting would be November 1st.
Right.
And that 28th would give us where we can open and close.
On the 1st.
On the 1st.
Okay,
and
great.
Get over to advisory and town council.
I'm good.
So with that said, we have November 1st.
The
5th. The 15th is our special town. Do we want to have a meeting before it, or...
We probably ought to allow
that. Yeah, we probably should, because we have to
but
have a meeting.
But should we set one for business?
For 5:30.
For 5:30?
You mean
Or are you going to go 7? So six, I'm sorry.
Well, the meeting's at 6:30. We'll meet at 6 with the advisory committee for any questions. We can meet at 5:30 if we have any business.
That would be.
So what time are we going to start?
5:30.
Yep.
To be posted at the elementary school. In
you want
the
5:30? Even though it's at 6, it's giving you an hour.
It'll, for Board of Selectmen issues?
Yeah.
If there are.
Now, should we have a meeting, try to get one in there with the advisory board?
Is that going to be with the
If there's some questions or anything?
Well, that'll be, we're going to do one with the advisory committee at 6. We can always meet the 8th if the advisory committee wants to do a joint.
Yeah.
Well,
we can't meet the 8th. That's election day, and usually don't have any meetings on election day.
Dave, do you guys meet the first week of November?
We can set a date anytime.
So worst case, we see what happens on the 28th, see if there's any huge issues. discuss it on the 1st, and worst case is we can meet maybe Thursday or Friday night with a 48-hour.
Well,
Veterans Day is, so you can't meet on, because that's a holiday.
No, over here.
Oh, you're talking over here, okay.
I don't see any major issues. This isn't like we're doing budget items.
Do we put on the agenda for the 18th the whole bridge, funding of the bridge, and have a conversation then with everybody in the room?
Yeah.
I'd almost say have a joint meeting on the 1st.
I'm just concerned at the lateness of that.
I don't think there's going to be much on the 1st.
No, I was just saying, if we could have a conversation in 2 weeks, it would be better.
We won't have all our articles in.
Well, are we asking for them to come in early?
On the 28th, but they have until the 28th.
Mm. Okay.
Dave, can you do a joint meeting on the 1st?
Of November?
Yep.
What day is that fall on?
Tuesday.
No, I'll run by the numbers, yeah. I don't have a problem.
Can you write that down for 6:30? We'll do a joint meeting. We'll do our regular meeting at 6, and then we'll do a joint at 6:30.
Yeah, they might prefer closer to 7.
We'll be done by then.
Yeah, I'll run by.
All right, thank you.
I mean, it's fine with me, but I know some members have a hard time.
Okay. So we have the 1st with a possible joint at 6:30 on the 1st.
I have that, yeah.
The 15th at 5:30.
29th.
And then you're going to do another joint at 6, or no? Skip that one at 6.
We can do a joint.
Yeah, because we usually go over
if there's
any
issues.
If there's any changes.
At Brookfield Elementary, and then joint at 6.
Yeah.
The 29th of November?
29th.
So 1:15:29.
December 13th?
Yeah.
Do we want to do the 27th because it's a holiday week? Well, one in December is good.
If something happens to come up, you know, in between time, we can always have Karen post it ahead of time.
What does January look like? Is it?
You got January 3rd, which is 2 days after.
So, okay. So shoot for January 3rd versus the 27th.
So January 3rd, January 17th. And January 31st.
Mm-hmm.
And that's 3 months.
Yep.
Do you have December 13th?
Just the 13th.
Just the 13th.
So I'll entertain a motion for those dates.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Item number 6, Mr. Snyder requested this agenda item. The floor is yours, sir.
I'd actually ask David to come forward because of the other two requests that were forwarded to the town. So you've had two other requests that have come to the town, to this board for information.
Okay.
And so I'd like to understand.
Well, what are the requests? Let everybody know what we're talking about.
There was employee hours. That was one of them.
Okay.
And you have
Do you have the emails, Clarence?
I have today's. I don't have.
That's the packet. That first one was Clarence's email.
So.
Yeah.
Oh, all right. So you've had requests into the town to the town accountant. And to the tax collector, am I correct?
That's right.
No, the treasurer.
You have a
treasurer, I think. Mostly.
It was the treasurer.
Treasurer. Yeah. And that those were sent forwarded to this body for, and I'm just trying to understand what the requests are.
Well, speak what you're talking about here.
Well,
Ask me the question, and then I will give you an answer.
What is the purpose of these requests?
Okay, what are the requests? Read them so people know what we're talking about.
Okay. So the treasurer on the 21st and discussed need for employee payroll information and timesheets.
Okay. What is your question?
What's the need for the request?
Request for the timesheets?
Yep.
We want to see who's doing what, who's working what hours.
Where
the money is being allocated, and if people are working the hours that they say they are. Because we're talking about, further down the line here, the whole process is we're discussing time clocks.
But that would just be for people that are like employees or are there appointed, that would not mean elected officials.
You know what, Linda? I'm tired of hearing, you know, elected, appointed, hired. You know what? Other towns I've talked to, if they're elected, they have to work X number of hours, period. You know, this elected crap.
No, they're working, elected people don't have to punch
time clock. I know how that law reads. But the point you just asked me is, why are we doing this?
Mm-hmm.
Because I've had a lot of people come to me, and a lot of people are not working their hours they're supposed to be working.
Okay.
So, okay, and we're also working on time clocks, as you know. We discussed this last year. So it all ties in together, and the whole process, we're just going over it, that's all.
So
we're not pointing fingers at anyone. We're just discussing the whole process.
Yeah, all right. And you understand the role of the advisory committee by law?
That's right.
And that the advisory committee's roles and responsibilities are referred to in Chapter 4, Section 1 of the town's bylaws?
Yeah.
And it suggests in that paragraph that if there were a warrant article that was provided to you by this body, that you would, in fact, could look to time cards and those kinds of things. But at this point, this body hasn't provided you a warrant article that talks to that cause.
Right. But you haven't got a warrant article yet because we're discussing it, because this may be a warrant article and we're discussing it in advance. We're doing our homework. So you can take that and do whatever you want, but we're going ahead and doing our homework.
All right.
It has to do with dollars and cents, and that's why we're discussing it.
I would say that this body has a responsibility, and that with that, we would then be providing direction to the advisory committee for its actions relative to time clocks or any other activity.
So why don't one of you members come to our board and talk to us?
What? Turn to the chairman.
That's what I'm requesting. I'm requesting one of you three members to come to our board when we have this discussion, and I'll make sure we have this discussion when one of you are there. How's that sound?
Okay. Well, David, I think in just the emotion here in a second.
No, there's no emotions. I'm just telling it the way it is.
I think it's time to, because we've had an employee meeting in the meantime of after these things, and I think they're all connected. And
okay.
Is it understood that you and the advisory committee are employees of the town under Mass General Law?
You could say that.
If you're going down the road, I think you're going, we're not going to entertain that discussion this evening.
Okay.
Why don't you just come right out, Clarence, and say what you have to say, and let's not beat around the bush.
We're not going to do that. Are you talking about what I think you're talking about?
Yep, I bet.
I'm not going to allow that tonight.
All right. Then do you want to schedule an executive session on that topic?
That's an executive session issue.
All right.
And one of you should come to the advisory board.
Okay.
And talk to the board.
And you know, Dave, and I've... At least monthly, I'm answering phone calls from the advisory committee, and that's like me being there as far as I'm concerned. Any questions you guys have ever asked, I've always answered.
Oh, yeah, we call you from the... Right. I understand that. But it's nice if one of you would sit in periodically with our meetings, because we'd like to get some input.
I'm not opposed to that, and like I said...
We'd like to get some input from you guys.
And I'm always available, and you always do ask for my input.
This isn't against you guys or us or any other boards in town. I mean, we're supposed to be working together to formulate something good for the town. We're in there volunteering our time, and we want some input and cooperation from you guys.
And in regards to this request, Clarence, I had a conversation with our treasurer, and she's deemed it through conversations she had that it's not illegal to give him the information that he'd like. And my recommendation is just to let
not me, the board.
Yep, but you're at the chair, so we're talking through you. Is to allow Dave just to sit in her office and go through what he can legally go through and take the information he needs to. It wouldn't hinder Sandy in any of her work, and it would give Dave what he needs to have the discussions that they want in that committee. I understand the bylaw, and as far as I'm concerned, every dollar that we talk about, they need to talk about.
Oh, absolutely.
It's not just warrants. The number one item on that is to approve the budget. And
that's totally agree.
So as long as it's not illegal, and if Dave wants to do that homework, I have no problem with it.
Because I just thought when I had saw it, I mean, that's a lot, you know, that's...
It is, it's a time...
It would take time out from the treasurer's everyday functions. It's a lot of work for her to have to do.
And that was, did you want to put these back in here, Clarence?
Yep.
And that was my only concern, was legality, not violating any of our employees. Our employees' information, because...
No, I told Sandy specifically I didn't want anything but ours.
And then
that's it.
And then Sandy's time, and I think she said she had the conversation with you that you had no problem coming in and doing what you had to do.
I guess it's how the questions have been asked of late.
100%.
What is your problem, Clarence, with this question by the board?
It's just how we're...
It seems like it bothers you.
Well, and it came out of the employee meeting that there's some concern as to how the employees are being approached. And the...
What do you mean approached?
Decorum between employees and yourself.
I don't understand.
How do you think you relate to the employees of the town?
I don't know. I have no idea. If I talk truth, it's not going to be too good with them.
And I think that's a concern, Mr. Chairman.
Right.
Because we are the town.
I've had a couple of employees speak to me.
All right, so let's have this discussion.
I haven't approached anyone except for the treasurer. He's the only one I've discussed this with.
On that topic.
Yeah.
And I would only ask as to your last relationship with the tax collector and your last conversation with the admin to the police department.
To who?
The admin, Holly.
I've had no problem with either one of them. None. Zero.
Okay.
All right, so we're okay with path that we want to proceed?
I think we need an executive session.
Okay. We'll set that. We don't need this meeting to do that, so. Any other questions for Mr. Holcraft?
No, you called me up here, so I'm trying to answer questions for you guys.
Well, thank you.
That's all you have?
Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Number 7, under other... conversation that I had with Representative Berthium lasted a while because I also discussed polls. His recommendation through his experience with the town of Spencer was to physically call in representatives from both National Grid and Verizon to sit and speak. We did that via email. They're passing the buck here and there.
Well, it was on Channel 7 News. It's not just our problem.
So,
I heard that too. It's not just a problem, it's a problem in many of our communities.
And I take, I'm searching for a nice politically correct word.
Probably isn't one.
It makes me angry because these polls have been in this town literally since I've been a board of selectmen member. And that's 6 years. And that's a long time. And every single board, every single year requests that these polls get taken care of.
Yeah, I remember it in the 3 years I've been in.
I have multiple accounts with National Grid. Mm-hmm. I have multiple accounts with Verizon. I fortunately, have only one account with Charter. If I was late on any of these bills for 1 month, let alone six years,
they'd come after us.
They would come after us with heavy litigation, they would disconnect service, yada, yada, yada. We, as a town, allow these entities to do service in this town, and they're not treating our customers to the respect that they deserve, and they need to be called.
Mm-hmm.
We need them in front of this board. It needs to be taken care of. Because what happens is when they come in for poll requests, we just deny. And I don't want to see that happen because all the pull requests that I've ever been involved with benefits a homeowner.
Sure.
Getting it out of their yard, freeing up lines, and that's just a horrible precedent that we'd have to set. But things have to happen because it's absolutely ridiculous.
Yeah.
And I don't think it should be tolerated anymore. So Karen's working really very diligently, and I commend her for that. Any further discussion on that? Correspondence. We received correspondence from the Worcester Community Housing Resource Incorporation in regards, again, to the Mass Attorney General Office. They're just basically stating that they're familiar with the Attorney General's program for abandoned houses.
Yeah, I saw that one.
But they're kind of piggybacking on it and helping out through demolitions and whatnot. Mm-hmm. So I would ask that we forward this to our Board of Health. All right. So we can forward that, Karen. Any other business before the board?
Just the other piece of correspondence that you might have seen about the Factory of Terror bulletin board.
That wasn't correspondence. Well, the emails, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so Clear Channel has been forthcoming to suggest that they're going to take the bulletin board down or billboard down across from the elementary school, so I thought that was good progress.
Are you biting your tongue as much as I am, Linda?
Well, I talked to her the other day.
Oh, you did? Okay.
I did also, and I told her that, you know, we would investigate it, and, you know, I told her that I'd bring it up before the board, and you are now,
mm-hmm.
and I found out she's not even a resident of our community.
But she's got a kid at the school.
Yeah, but still, I mean, I think that children see worse than
Well, it's not only that,
when they turn the TV on, I mean, and then if they go out for even Halloween, they're going to see scary things.
So for those that are listening, there was a complaint, not only one billboard, but two billboards in the center, yep. in the town of Brookfield, with, was it the...
Factory of Terror.
Yeah.
I forget, was it like a ghoul or a goblin
it's
or something?
It's like a pretty
ugly skeleton.
Yeah. Coming out, this is the second year, I guess there was a complaint on it.
Yep.
I speak from experience that by Carmela's, that billboard that's there, that's one of the complaints. I rented that billboard for a month.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to tell you what, if the company came to me and said that I'm pulling your ad off that you just spent $2,500 for, I'd have a real issue with it.
Oh, and they're working it.
So I think Clearview needs to have, through. Obviously we don't want to scare kids.
No, I know we don't want to scare kids, but they see things. I mean, they can turn the TV on.
It's Halloween.
It's Halloween. They're going to see things.
So, all right.
They're working with their supply.
So I would ask that if you continue to have communication with them, is maybe have them earmark certain bulletin boards where they are in relationship to different things. We do that with our bylaws, you know, marijuana, distilleries or whatever, dispensaries. Maybe they can do that within their own policies. But we're talking about America. So I've spoke my two cents more than I wanted to tonight.
She was a very kind social...
100%.
Customer service person. I thought that was noble that they were going to step forward.
I can't believe they even stepped forward to that.
I didn't either.
My mouth dropped when I saw that email. Yeah. But I commend you for reaching out.
I just sent a note. Yeah. What could you do? And she came back and said they're going to work it. So, hey, I'm all for it.
I'm biting my lip again now.
There you go.
Thank you.
Yeah. You're welcome.
Any other business before the board this evening? Entertain a
time
motion to adjourn.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you, everyone.